Egyptian warplanes struck ISIS targets in Libya Monday, just hours after the extremist group released the horrific video showing a mass beheading of 21 Christian hostages. The Egyptian government and the Coptic Church both say it's authentic. The militants claim loyalty to ISIS and identify themselves as the Tripoli province of the Islamic State group. The killings raise concerns the Islamic militant group, which controls about a third of Syria and Iraq, has now established a direct affiliate in North Africa, less than 500 miles from the southern tip of Italy. One of the militants in the video, speaking English, makes direct reference to that possibility, saying the group now plans to, quote, conquer Rome. Relatives and friends of the hostages say they were targeted because they were Christians and voted for Egyptian President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, a former army chief. Abanoub Ishak is a colleague of the Egyptian Coptic Christian hostages in Libya. He said they are targeting us because we voted for el-Sisi and because we are Christians. In Libya, they say that the Christians are the sons of el-Sisi and are targeting us for that matter. If only Christians voted for el-Sisi, he wouldn't have won the elections. Egyptian President el-Sisi declared, Egypt reserves the right to respond at the proper time and in the appropriate style in retaliation for those inhuman criminal killers. CBN News reporter George Thomas is in Nigeria and spoke about how the threat of ISIS is spreading into different countries.
Like ISIS, like Al-Qaeda, Al-Shabaab in Somalia, Boko Haram in Nigeria, the Al-Qaeda in the Maghreb, these groups find locations, ungoverned, undergoverned areas, and that's where they thrive.
This latest ISIS atrocity comes as Congress debates President Obama's war powers request to take on ISIS, with many Republicans saying the president's move is not strong enough to truly battle ISIS, which is expanding its influence beyond Iraq and Syria. And the former Obama defense secretary warned that ISIS is a threat beyond the Middle East.
We're dealing with an enemy that has strong command and control, and we're dealing with an enemy that is well armed. ISIS is a whole new chapter in terms of the terrorist threat to this, to that area and to our country.
Mark Martin, CBN News.